So here's an example of an inequality in one variable, like x is greater than or equal to 2, right? And now, this is only one variable. It's just like one dimension, only one parameter. We only need to know anything about one variable. So if I give you an idea of where 2 is, like it's here, and then I tell you that x can be more than that, like I put all these points over here, including this point at 2 because x can be equal to 2, then there you go, we've graphed it. But now if we have two variables, now they have to work together to make an inequality true. Okay, so here's our first example. But if not just x has to be greater than or equal to 5, but x plus y has to be greater than or equal to 5, let's start by telling there's literally limitless possibilities here. Can anybody just throw out a combination of an x and a y that makes this true?
6 and 1, or 5 and 1.
5 and 1?
Yeah, 5.
No, we're going to need 4 and 1.
Oh. 5 and 1, well, let's see.
It's 6.
6, does that make the inequality true?
Yeah.
It does, right? It's bigger than 5, so that's fine.
More.
We keep track of this by plotting this as a point, as we have so many times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1.
Okay.
So then I heard 4, 1. Does 4, 1 work?
Yes.
Why does it work?
Because it's 5.
And it's okay that it's equal to 5,
because
we got that guy right there, right? So it's okay that it's equal to 5. So 4, 1.
But doesn't that sign mean that it has to be greater than 5?
Yeah, but this also means
it could be equal
to as well. All right. We're gonna do a bunch of these until we start to see a pattern take shape.
I don't want to make it
false. 1.1
plus 1. Well, we want to make it true.
Oh.
So what's one that makes it true?
4.1 plus 1.
Let's do whole numbers. Keep
three
it simple.
And three.
You're right, but
3 and 2.
2, 3,
2.
That works.
6.4.
6.4. Well, 6 plus 4 is 10, which is bigger than 5, so that absolutely works.
Double it. Just double it.
Oh. 7 minus 4.
What's that?
Oh. 7 minus 4. 7 and -2.
7 and -2. That's pretty clever. 7 for x and -2 for y. 7 minus 2 is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, -2. Keep them coming. Just keep throwing them out there.
9 and 9.
9 and 9.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I hope this is on.
It's a long 6 and 0.
6 and 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 0.
6, -1.
There. 6, -1. 6, -1. Because 6 minus 1 is 5.
Yeah.
What else?
5 and 0.
3 and 10.
5 and 0.
Nine and 10.
Shelby said something about a line. Might be something pretty good to think about.
That's gonna be one messed up line.
The slope is like a barrier.
If we connect all these together, we'll make like a sledgehammer.
Let's throw in a bunch more that just.
It looks
this.
Like there's going to be a line.
Oh,
looks like there's going to be a line going.
10, -5.
Oh, it looks like 2 lines.
6 or 3 lines, because it looks like there's a line going this way, and then there's a line going this way, and then straight across from the main.
Okay.
Line.
Well, let's get a bunch more points and see if that continues to.
Wait, what do you have people right?
10 and 10.
Well, let's see. Let's just keep throwing points down. Let's talk about just the equal part right now. So, like, you know, 6, -1, 5, 0, 4, 1, all these guys are making both sides equal. What's that?
I said 6 minus 1.
You got 6 minus 1?
Yeah, yeah.
You have another one? Another x and y that will make a 5?
7 minus 2.
So, yeah.
Got that one.
Oh, I got this.
7 minus 5.
10 minus 5.
7 minus 1.
8 minus 1.
I mean, this is, I can't really go so far, but this is 10.
Minus 10. 15 minus 10.
10 minus 5. There we go.
1, 5.
10, 7.
Let's stay with the ones that make it exactly 5. Okay, I'm gonna cut it off at 10, right? I can't go all the way out to 15. I'm running out of room here.
9 minus 4.
9 minus 4. 9 -4. 9 -4.
9 -4.
What's that?
8 -3.
8 -3. You see this? You see a pattern? Keeps going down. Like the bigger x I get, the more negative the y could be, right?
6-1.
I love you, man.
6-1. 6-1. It does make the inequality true. I'm looking, though, for. I'll open it down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, I do.
I'm looking for ones that make a 5 on the side.
2-3.
2-3.
3,
3.
3, oh,
so
you
got
3-2.
Yeah. We have 3-2. 2-3.
5-0.
Got
5-0
already.
You have 9-4.
1-4.
1-4. We got 9. Maybe I have 9-4. We have that already, actually. 1-4?
Yes.
1-4.
How about 2-3?
Last.
We
got 2-3
both.
Already, actually. 2-3 right there.
But I don't see it up there.
7.
Yeah, I'm putting them down. I have not written it down as an older pair for a while.
7-3.
We already have that, actually.
Negative
7-3.
Yes.
8-3.
What's
that?
8-5. That actually.
0-5.
How about negative 1?
I got 5-0.
8-3.
0-5 is different.
It's different, guys.
How about negative 1? 6?
Yeah.
Negative 2?
7.
Negative 3, 8.
Negative
4, 9. Are we seeing a pattern?
Yes.
What pattern are we seeing?
When you try to hold one number for an inequality through both variables, it makes a straight line with the slope.
I have to wait for Dylan.
It makes a straight line. Now, this shouldn't be all that surprising because when we graph a line, that's exactly what we're graphing, right? All of the points, all the x's and y's that make two sides of an equation equal to each other, right? At least it's set up in such a way that those numbers, like we can get a different shape if we had like a square or a cube in there, but we don't. They're all to the first power, okay? And so we do get a line, but okay, now let's do some that make it greater than. Make the x plus y greater than 5. We've done a few. Let's be realistic.
Five plus six.
5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, comma. We already have 5, 1, 5, 6. There's 5, 6.
You have a 5, 7.
5-3. I heard 5-2 earlier.
Yay.
5-3.
5-4.
4.
5-5.
5.
5-7.
7.
9-8.
9-9. 6-1.
You
don't have 5.
You're
going to
run out of room here. What's that?
You can always do like a negative 5 and then start moving down.
Yeah.
Do a negative 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
What if the 5 be
like?
5-1.
Yeah,
-5, -1.
No,
yeah,
5-1.
Oh, 5-1. What would be 5 and -1? 5 + -1.
4.
Would that be true?
Yeah.
5 + -1 = 4. Is 4 greater than or equal to 5?
No.
Is that a point that we should plot?
No.
We shouldn't plot that one. Other
6,
points.
2.
6-2. I think we have that one. 6, no we don't, 6-2.
6-3.
Okay.
6-5.
6-7.
6-8.
6-9.
6-10.
7-1. You guys are going
to
make him lose his mind. Just so on.
7-2.
Just like,
that
just
that
put a dot on each line.
What's that?
Just from the point on, from both sides, just put a dot on each line.
Where?
Above.
7.
This
five.
Is what we're looking for right here.
7-0.
Dylan's
zero.
Made a revelation.
Yes.
Okay. All of the points that we could plot forever and ever, Where do you think they're going to wind up?
On the other side of that graph.
Yeah.
4-1.
There, I like, now Dylan said above it, and I think that's a good way to think of it, above it.
Yes.
As opposed to the right
yes.
of it, which it also could kind of feel that way too.
Yeah.
I would say above it. If you think of it as above, then what I say later will make a lot more sense.
The only
one is above. So, I could put points anywhere up here. Would you believe that those two numbers together would make this side bigger than
yes.
this side?
Yes.
No.
Well, this one
no.
makes it equal, right? Kind of line. Well, if I go up from there and I make the y value bigger, well, then I bet it would be bigger than 5.
Yeah.
No. All of these guys, and how long will it take me to draw in all those dots?
Until you color it in.
Until you
how long will that
until you make
until
a solid
roll
draw.
It out the kid.
When will it be?
Easy.
You will die. I will die before I finish. So, we have to just kind of pretend like I did it. Right? And shade it in. When I shade it in, what am I really doing?
Everything.
Shading
everything.
Shading in what? Points. Like all of these infinite number of points that make the left side of this equation bigger than the right side. Okay? I see approximately 0 people writing this down.
Oh, sorry.
should see a graph, too.
I think
graphs,
I got it.
That's what we're after here.
So
while you do that, let's talk about the pattern we just saw. What was the first thing we noticed as we were plotting all of these points?
There was a straight line.
2 of them, actually.
There's a comment.
I was going to make 3, but then...
Well, I think that other line turned out be like an illusion or a coincidence. This one that was kind of going off in this direction. It just so happened that we had plotted a point there and a point here and it looked like we're having a line. But the line wouldn't continue this way because what would these points down here do?
Nothing.
Well, if we were to take a point from here and plug in that x and y, what would happen? What would we get here?
We should have something less than or equal to 5.
Anything down here would be less than 5, and then
yeah.
be useless to us because that doesn't fit the inequality we've been talking about. So we found a straight line, and then what was the second thing we noticed about all those other points?
They're above the line.
Okay, so straight line, and then like half the plane as the other points. Does that make sense?
Yes.
I don't know.
Remember, the plane means just this flat, infinite in all directions surface, right, that we grab onto, we draw a graph onto. So it seems like half of it is going to be shaded in, right?
Somewhat.
And now it's kind of hard to talk about half of infinity, but it's a fair description. Half of the plane, half of all of this infinity is going to have points that they don't make it equal. That's what the line does. If the points on the line make it equal, the other points make it, well, unequal in whatever way this inequality is saying. In this case, all the points above make it greater than. What if we were to take this and turn it around, like that?
Now all the dots have to go underneath it.
All of the dots would come underneath, right. So we should expect every time we do this that we will find a straight line, and then there'll be a half of the line, right, either above it or below it, half of the plane above the line or below the line, then we're going to shade in. We can figure that out and start on the home. That's what it takes. Let's do a few more examples though. Okay, so if you work on the homework, do so silently for a bit. Let's talk about 2x plus y is greater than 7, yes? I feel like you've got it down. But you have a couple of tips. You may want to hang out. Okay. Let's do this one again in the just kind of random guessing and checking kind of a way. All right, and then I'll give you a tip. Yes, all of those.
There's not a lot, guys.
Okay.
That's all.
So, what we said before, now we've got a good strategy here. We should wind up with a line, right? And half of the plane should be covered in points, right? So if we know there's going to be a line, then we really just need to find two points that are on that line, and we found the line. Okay? Let's remind ourselves back from this example. Where did the line come from? What was going on in this inequality that generated the line?
X plus y is greater or equal to 5.
Was it either or?
Greater or, yeah.
The points strictly on the line. Was there something very particular about those ones? I mean, they generated a line with a slope 5. What's special about the lines, or the points on the line? What do they do that's different from all those other points when you plug them into the inequality? The ones on the line do?
Or, yeah,
equal to 5. Equal to 5, yeah, let's try a few of them out. 0, 5. 0, 5, equal to 5. 1, 4, 1 plus 4, 5. 2, 3, 2 plus 3, 5. All the points on the line make both sides of the inequality, and here you say it.
Equal
to each other. Now, can you tell me a point, like an x and a y, that will make both sides of this equal? Any two numbers that you can make work.
2 and 3.
2 and 3. 2 times 2 is 4, plus 3, 7. Right? Let's write it out in full detail here. 2 times 2 plus 3 greater than 7. Okay?
3, 1.
So 2, 3. But here's the thing I want to ask you. Is there anything wrong with this? It would need equal to. Is 7 greater than 7?
No, it's the same.
Right, so 7 needs to be greater than 7, but something Shelby said earlier is like the line is like this barrier between points that work and points that don't. So we still want the line, it's just that the line, we don't want the points that are right of the line. We just want the ones that are just off of the line and like on that other half of the plane, right? So when I go to 2 comma 3, just to make this point clear, I'll put an open circle, right? That point isn't work, but it's really close to points that do work. So that point does not work because it makes both sides exactly equal, which it can't be. But if I were to choose this point, like that guy right above it, right? That's 2 comma 3.1. 2 comma 3.1. Will that work? 3.1. 2 times 2 is 4, plus 3.1 is 7.1, 7.1, 7.1. So now that point works, it's just that this guy...
Greater
by 0.1.
3-0?
3-0.
Yeah.
Yeah,
well.
3-0. 2 times 3
plus 0. 6. Is that greater than 7? Oh, that's why you have that argument.
Let's do 1. Let's put a 1 in there. What do we get? 2 times 3 is 6.
7. That equals 7.
Plus 1. But it is a point on that line, and that line is helpful. That line is a barrier between things that do work and things that don't work. So 3, 1 we'll go to and put an open circle. Now I can stop because I know that there's going to be a straight line. And I found two points that are on the line. The line is where the both sides are equal. And so, there it is. There's the line. It's the barrier between points that work and points that don't. But points on the line are not going to work in this inequality. So in the same way that we use open circles to say, like, well, this point isn't actually going to work, we use a dotted line.
Why would you do an open circle?
Because this point is at, let's say this one, 2, 3.
Yeah.
When I plug 2, 3 into this inequality, let's find out what happens.
Whoa.
2 for x, 3 for y. This is where we wind up. Is that true?
No.
No, it's not. But it's so close to being true, right? If this sign were just any tiny bit bigger,
there's a point bigger,
then it would be true, right?
Yeah.
So this is right, like this 2, 3 puts us right on the border of points
so
that work and points
exactly
that don't.
Exactly right. You put
when it makes both sides equal to each other, what we have found is a point on the line, a point on the line, right? And any point on this line will make both sides equal. Now, we don't want both sides to be equal, but when they are equal, we're just like one tiny, tiny fraction away from a point that will make the left side bigger than the right side. Does that make sense? So we need to find that line. Like, you need to know where that barrier is. That line is the barrier between the points that make the left side bigger and the points that make the left side smaller. Right in the middle of being smaller and bigger is exactly the same. So we find those 2 points, just any 2 points, that give us that line that makes both sides equal, and we found the barrier. And so if that's the barrier, then we either need to find a bunch of points up here, or there's a bunch of points down here that work.
0, 9.
0, 9 works? Let's see where that is. That's up here. Let's see, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's above it, right? Is that a point that works? Plug in 0, 9. 0 plus 9. That's greater than 7. So that point came from above. So all the other points, where do you think they're going to come from?
Above
the line. So we can just randomly grab a point, see if it works. If it works, then all the other points around it must also work. See? So you gotta find that line. And then figure out which half works. Right? By which half works, I mean it has all the points to make that inequality true. And in this case, like the left side needs to be bigger than the right side. If we were to switch this inequality around, then all the points below would be the one that would work. We gotta find that line and then figure out which half works. So now for the tip. Tip of how to find that line.
Hmm? I thought you said test.
I was like, now for the tip.
Okay.
Of how to figure out where that line is. How many times have we graphed a line?
A lot.
A lot of times. Okay. And we're pretty good at it when it comes to y equals mx plus b. Y-intercept, slope. Y-intercept, slope. So if we can get this inequality to look like y equals mx plus b, we can find the line easily, and then we just have to find which half to shade in. We can do that by adding 3x to both sides, right? Getting y by itself. Making it look like y equals mx plus b. Y is greater than or equal to 3x plus 4. Y is greater than or equal to 3x plus 4. If we had this, y equals 3x plus 4, we could graph that line. We graph it just like this. Y intercept of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Slope of what?
3 over 1.
Slope of 3 over 1, we would go over 1 and up 3. Over 1 and up 3. And then we would connect those points and make a line. But I'm going to draw that dotted line here. Why? Can someone remind us who's seen it once? Why do we put a dotted line instead of a solid line? Because.
Nope.
I said it wrong. It's connected instead of dotted. It's solid instead of dotted because we have this equal to part. If they're equal to, then that works. And the points on the line are the ones that make both sides exactly the same, exactly equal. So we found that line then. Again, that's the barrier, that's the cutoff. If you're on one side of this line, then you make the inequality work. If you're on the other side, you make the inequality false. Okay. So how are we going to find the side with all the points that make the inequality true?
You know, whatever is next to x is going to be the slope.
Well, we've used the slope. So So how do I find a point? Is the, are the, all the points coming from here, or should all the points come from here?
There.
Why?
Because it's above the positive slope.
It's above the positive slope.
Makes more sense.
What it means. Exactly.
Because positive slope you expect it to be up, and negative slope you expect it to be down.
Doesn't really matter what the slope is. You can have points above a positive slope, you have points above a line on the negative slope.
Okay, then.
So, here, let's do the easy way. The easy way is we know half of, half should be shaded in, the other half shouldn't. So let's just randomly grab a point. If it works, it must have come from the side that's supposed to be shaded in. If it doesn't work, it must have come from the side that shouldn't. And I'm gonna pick the easiest point I can think of, 0, 0. If it works, then it was part of the shaded part. And if it doesn't, it's part of the other part. We should shade the other side. 0 > 3 × 0 + 4. 0 > 4, is that true or false?
Sometimes it's both.
It's both true and false?
I think it's just false.
It is false. Is 0 > 4?
No.
Is 0 = 4?
No.
So it's not true. That's false. Well, that means that this point, 0, 0, must come from the blank side. The side that doesn't have any points, this must be the side with all those points. There they are. Okay. So if you were to follow my tip, I would say make it look like y equals b.
I got that.
Then test a point. And once you know whether that point worked or didn't work, you'll know which side you're supposed to shade. Either it worked and you shade the side that point is on, or it didn't work and you shade the other side. Also notice this, you can tell which side to shade from this. We'll do more examples, but let me just say, okay? Here's y, and it needs to be greater than. Y needs to be greater than something. When I look in the graph, where is y on the graph? It's a really hard question. Yeah, up and down, that's all you can say about the general question, where is y? It's up and down. Up and down. So this thing that's up and down, vertical, needs to be greater. Where did greater things come from when we're talking about up and down? Did it come from up or did it come from down?
Up.
So this vertical thing, it needs to be greater than something. So all the stuff that you need is up there, right? Greater than comes from up there. So if you see y is greater than, which you see y by itself, y is greater than, you already know you're going to shade above the line. If it were less than, well, less than things come from down below. Below the line. It's two different ways that you can figure out which side to shade.
If it's this way, it's above. It's this way, below.
Yeah.
Okay.
Otherwise, you can just pick a test point, test it. If it works, great, shade that side. If it doesn't, shade the other side. Look like y equals mx plus b. Of course, this one's going to look like y is greater than mx plus b. When I get y by itself. So the first thing we're going to do that, we can subtract 2x. Subtract 2x through y is greater than negative 2x plus 6. And divide by 3 to get y by itself. And y needs to be greater than negative 2/3 x. There's your slope. Plus 6 divided by 3 is 2. So I have a y-intercept of 2. I have a slope of negative 2/3, so I'm going to go down 2 and divide 3. So I found 2 points on that line, on that barrier between points that work, points that are solutions to that inequality, and the other half that don't work. And I'm going to draw this a dotted line. Because if I take a point from on the line, it'll make both sides of this equal. I want them to be equal. I want the left side to be greater. So points of the line do not work. Points of the line do not. So that's why we have a dotted line. If we had an equal to here, then we would have a solid line. But we don't. It's just greater than, so dotted line. A dotted line is like the line version of an open circle. Points on the line.
You just want to do like a little scribble where the dots is.
It's fine. As long as it's obvious what you're doing there. So we either shape up here or we need to shape it down here. You can do the test point method where we find any point. We test any point. If it works, we shade that side. If it doesn't, we shade the other side.
Don't you try the point to go?
If it's as long as it's not on the line, that's one I would always pick.
Okay.
Because it's easy. It's super easy. Right. I can put it in here, it would be, I think, a little easier. 0 + 0 = 0. Is that true? It's not 0, it's not greater than 6. So this is from the unshaded half. So the shaded half must be up here.
Oh, what's that?
This one that
y is less
than x
minus 2. You see where that 8 is? So
where?
Let's do the 8 with the x and then the 3 with the y.
You have to add the 4.
So we found the half, and just a quick, again, I'll say this. Y needs to be greater than y is vertical.
So
vertically, y, like vertically greater than, like things that are larger, larger numbers come from up. Like the more up I go, the bigger numbers I find.
So y has to be greater than.
Well, in this case, because we started with what we started with, it winds up, you know, y needs to be greater than -2/3 x plus.
Okay.
2. If it says that y needs to be greater than, well, y is vertical. Vertically, greater things come from up, so we shade up above the line. Like in purple, I'm going to show the other side of it. Y is less than -2/3 x plus 2. Well, now y needs to be less than something. Y is vertical. Vertically, things that are less come from down below. So we shade down below. So the purple, right, is the less than half. The red is the greater than half. Right in the middle, this is what you would get if both sides were equal to each other. This one's set up for you. Why don't you give this one a try just for practice, and then I'll do it up on the board. Okay, so this already looks like y equals mx plus b. If I were to just graph the line that makes both sides equal, then I'd have a y-intercept of -3. There it is right there. The slope of 3/5, up 3/5. 4/5. Okay, so the line that is the barrier between all of those points that make the left side less and the left side greater than is this line right here. And it cannot be equal to, so we're going to use a dotted line. Dotted line. And we just have to decide, are the points that make the left side less than, do they come from here or do they come from here? We can try a test point like 0, 0, which is a nice convenient test point. Is 0 less than 0 minus 3? And since 0 is not less than negative 3, that side does not work, so we shade in the other side. I can also tell that I'm supposed to shade below the line because y is vertical and y needs to be less than and less than. Vertical is down.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Okay.